Now let's review the model and view in a bit more detail. The model is going to be super simple. It's just our data, an array of cat objects with properties for name, click count, and image URL. Nothing new here. Now the view, well, actually, if we want to, we can split this up into two views. First, we have the list of cats, and second, we have the cat viewing area. Both of these views will be pretty simple. They'll just have render functions that redraw the respective areas. And they'll have click handlers registered for the various cats up here and for the image down here. Now, why am I splitting them up into two views? Well, here's a good way to think about this. Think about how separate they are functionally. Not with regard to action, but with regard to what gets rendered. The list renders a list of cats. When does this re-render? Well, right now, it only renders one time at the start of the application. This other part renders cat details, and it gets re-rendered every single time you click on the cat. Now, they're both separate visually and in terms of when they get rendered. Separation does make some sense here. Now, if you wanted to make them one view, that would work just fine, but it's generally a good idea to separate out functionality into smaller chunks whenever it's possible.